Twitch. In just a second, I'll start doing today's cartoon. Thank you for coming. Hello there on YouTube. I think I'm ready to roll. Okay, so big in the news today is the crash in the stock market. And I've done lots of crashing stock market cartoons. This time the crash in the stock market is being attributed to a drop in the price of oil. And a few days ago, it was being attributed to a drop in the Chinese stock market. So, hey, when it's attributed to something different, it's time for a new cartoon. So today's cartoon is going to be a sinking oil, sinking the stock market cartoon. And I have drawn similar things before. Let's take a look at a few other recent ones. So these are the dropping price of oil. Make that a little bigger. On Iran and on Venezuela and on Russia, Putin, a clunky oil barrel is an excellent oil to fall. What else we got? Here's the last one I drew a few days ago with China falling on the bull, the Wall Street stock market. And here's one from quite a while ago. This one's kind of got every cliche in the book, huh? The rich pig, the red and the blue for the donkey and the elephant, and taxes sinking everybody down, but us more than the rich folks, huh? Another sinking stock market cartoon. In fact, every so often I can just bring this one back. They need to print it again, huh? This one is what inspired what I plan to draw today. This was actually quite a popular cartoon. You know, a vertical cartoon like this is not going to get much attention. But, hey, they like to leave a standard hole in the newspaper, let you fill the standard hole, and not worry about moving their layout around, most editors. But, you know, I think it's good to force them to have to accept something new every so often. So, hey, there's a few of you watching on both YouTube and Twitch right now. Please chat, give me something to respond to, and I will talk to you while I draw. So today's drawing is going to be similar to this one with Obama, the anchor. And it's going to be the Wall Street bull weighed down by the barrel of oil. So, ready to roll. Leave me some comments. So, to the drawing board. So, let's get the bull up here at the top of the water. He's upset. The bull mouth differs from a donkey mouth. Bull mouth has a kind of a turned up. Bull has kind of a turned up nose. It's good for those big, interesting nostrils. You have his mouth open, screaming bull. You know, I figure all this stuff out as I draw it. It's not like I figure everything out in advance. Maybe grit teeth is better. bigger eyes. Yeah, I think that's working. His ears over here. Well, let's see. I like for necks to attach to heads horizontally. Let me give him a wife beater t-shirt like I did on the donkey. Kind of pleased with the way the donkey was looking here, so I think I'm gonna stick with something generally similar. There you go. I guess I can draw over here. So arm up, arm out that way. This is the call for help hand. He's got human body on it. Cow head on human body. So you few people that are watching this, please come subscribe, like my page. Thank you for watching. And have something to say rather than sitting there so quietly. I'm going to give him a foot up, and then this foot is way down this way. That foot doesn't need to be that much up, so I don't obscure this arm so much. So another change I made today on YouTube was calling this a how-to video rather than a news and politics video. That doesn't seem to make much difference, does it? Give him his big swim shorts. Wife beater. Someone's gonna comment. How inappropriate is for you to use the term wife beater? Yeah, it's a little better. So water splashy. I actually have a little more room to work with in this composition with the oil, because I don't have to have that height of Obama the anchor holding me back. So I'm going to have this tied on with a rope. So he's going to have a knot and a loop and a couple of ends rope. Around his foot. So toe. I may do a how-to video just on feet. I did one a couple days ago on drawing hands that you should watch. I think it's pretty different than other kinds of how to draw hands videos you see, because I'm emphasizing more how you draw hands as a cartoonist and why hands are important to composition and expression and how you use that. I'm going to do the other big question I get asked a lot is how do you color your cartoons? And so I think I'm going to do a video soon on how to color your cartoons. Talk about the mistakes people make when they color their cartoons. It's actually good for coloring any kind of line drawing. If you guys have any requests on particular topics that you would like for me to do a little explainer video about, now that I've endeavored to try to do more videos, Let me know. I'll take it under advisement. I've got to come up with topics for videos, huh? Give his arm a little more interesting arm character. Show a little bit of anatomy. He's got his shoulder going on there. A little more elbow over there. That's better. He could have a little more girth too. Tiny hint of a pot belly, because he is a rich capitalist, huh? Even though you don't comment, you know what a rich capitalist this bull is. Alright, knee up here. I'm just mapping things out. You know, this is a rough sketch that I'm gonna draw over with final line art. And the final line art, I'm gonna use this as advisory material only, because I really redraw when I come back to do the heavy line art in pencil, which will be what people think is ink. And as you all know, I draw with a heavy hand and a hard pencil so that I can discourage myself from doing lots of rendering, which I tend to do. That's one of my own weaknesses that I have noted. So, develop your procedures to deal with your weaknesses. A little bit of waste poking through there. And the next stock market dump might have another popular explanation leading to yet another cartoon than China or oil. Could be a noose tying this oil on, huh? Now he needs a couple of floppy man boobs. That's looking a little better. A little more chin shadow. He's gonna have a couple good eye bags going on there. No messages from anybody yet. My goodness. Right. Okay. Oil barrel. Let's give it a little good standard perspective. One, two, three, four. It's like an oil barrel. Generally, you want to draw something that's got cylinder shape. It's a good idea to draw it first as rectangles rather than circles, so I can get my perspective going a little better this time. That's a little bit thick. All right. Planning this stuff out and getting the perspective right is a pain in the butt. But, you know, cartoons are forgiving, so I don't have to worry about perspective too much. And this is a pretty forgiving thing that's going to have some pretty incorrect for perspective. But you know, oil can has these ridges on it, these reinforcing ridges, give it a little oil can crush strength. So I need to draw those bulgy things going on. Then I can just tie the thing around it and call it an oil barrel. Is that the thing I want? Do I want it to be only that? I think I do. Now see if you guys would just comment. I could have something more interesting to say. Okay, let's go with this. Let's delete that. I think the most shocking thing about my videos is that what seems like it would be, you know, I'm not liking that one bit. Erase the whole thing. Start over, do a new oil drum. No comments from anyone. All right, let's try this again. We want this to be here. There's that. 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 I'm going to give it one ridge. Maybe I'm not going to do a ridge at all. I'll just do this as the... Write oil on it real big. I'm going to need a little bit of water details. Oh, Lazarus is saying something. Lazarus writes, you've drawn this idea, but with an anchor. What was your thought on the debate last night? Yes, I just showed the donkey and Obama as an anchor image, which you can see here. The debate last night was entertaining. I enjoyed the debate. But Donald Trump did pretty well. He handles the audience booing at him very well. They're all pretty, except for Jeb Bush, they're all pretty slick at dealing with the audience, which they should be. They spend so much time doing that. Lazarus, it's nice to see you come back. You're like my only regular visitor. And if you didn't see the beginning of this video, it is flattering that you remembered my similar cartoon with Obama the anchor. That cartoon actually got picked up pretty well, and pleased with how it went. So I'm not as worried in this case about cartoon not getting picked up much because it's got a non-conforming format. I'm going to draw the bottom of the sea here. If it's dull, I might add a little fish. A couple of little fishes. Do I want to add fishes? Could. The big thing that I'm going to talk about on my How to Draw Feet video is how beginners tend to draw feet with like their little letter L's. The leg goes down and the foot goes down in front of it like the letter L. And that's just wrong, because it's just as important to draw that heel pointing out to the back as it is the rest of the front pointing out in front of the leg, and the beginners have trouble with that. Foot needs to support the weight. Lazarus on YouTube writes, I missed some of the debate. What did Cruz say about New York that upset everyone? I don't remember the exact quote, but it was something equating Trump with a New York attitude. New York attitude presumably being that they're more liberal and more regulatory, more Jewish perhaps. And Donald Trump came back and very effectively defended New Yorkers and recalled their heroic efforts after the World Trade Center bombing. I think a lot of Republicans count on natural red state opposition to those blue state liberals, so just mentioning California gets a guffaw from the crowd. Oh, fruits and nuts and taco huts. And I think he was doing much the same thing with New York. Ugh, California liberals. Ugh, New York. All right. Probably enough of a sketch. Do I want any fish in this? If I do, it's going to have to be a little afterthought, like little fish down here. Couple little fish. Three fish. Except one looking over here. Little fish are fun. Just give the background a little bit of character. Okay. What do we think? I think that's good for me to start doing the finish. Put the signature over here. Good, good, good. Another thing I thought I might do, if I could get more of an audience going for these videos, is I might do like a weekly cartoon in review discussion of the cartoons that came in the week, what's going on with the international point of view on all these. That could be cute, but I've got to establish an audience first, so silent people that watch, please like my page, subscribe to my page on Facebook or Twitch. Is that what I like? Am I happy with this? I think so. He's struggling to stay above the water. Now, do I really want him to wear the wife beater and shorts, or should I have him in a business suit? I'm going to have a little existential moment while I discuss this. Lazarus writes on YouTube, I find these debates hilarious. They slam one another, then all join together to slam the Democratic candidates. Yep. Once you've been slamming your buddies on the stage and you realize how bad you sound to the audience, good to do a few everybody stick together kind of comments. Let's see what I think of him in a suit. If he has a suit, it's going to go this way. Yeah, I think if you're going to be sure that he's Wall Street, he's going to need to have a suit. That was my mistake from looking at the other cartoon, thinking I should do the wife beater in shorts. Donkey doesn't really require a suit to be a Democrat, but I think perhaps the bull requires a suit to be Wall Street. Pinstripe suit, probably. So my apologies on that. He's going to have a suit. I think I'm also going to have to give him shoes, huh? Alright, let's do that. This is going to change to a suit. My apologies, folks. I just decided, as I'm going along, that it needs to be a suit. So, the shoe... I give him a different shaped foot within the shoe, because it's not so much fun to have his toes flaring. So, we'll go with shoe over here. Go a little bit on the underside for this shoe. And I guess that's right. And then this shoe, back like that. Ah, I have some nice comments over here on Twitch. Number one, Kills says, let's do it. All right, we'll do it, Kills. Wow, not 4chan. Are you calling Obama an ass? And she writes, nice Cagle. So, well, or he writes, I don't know if wow, not 4chan is a boy's name or a girl's name, but thank you for your comments. Am I calling Obama an ass? Sure. I don't like Obama. I tend to be liberal, or liberal leaning. So I dislike Obama for the Bernie Sanders kind of reasons why people wouldn't like Obama. I don't like that he didn't send any Wall Street types to jail after they raped and stole all the money in the economy. But hey, just gotta appreciate that those are his buddies. They, you know, they give him money. Gotta stand up for your bros, huh? So, no, I don't like that. I want to see the bad Wall Street crooks go to jail. That's what makes me most angry about Obama. The Elizabeth Warren kind of rant. Oh, Lee Hawkeye 101 writes, Carbine has said that lower-level buildings take fewer settlers to build. I don't know what you're talking about. You guys are talking to each other. Well, if you talk to me, I will respond. Okay. I'm fine with people talking to each other, but doesn't give me much to talk about. All right, now I'm standing up and getting my drafting vellum. You know, I do... I do the final art on nice drafting vellum. It's looking a little tall, isn't it? I think I might squeeze it down a little bit as I draw this. Okay. You guys, I have no idea what you're talking about on Twitch. Talking about games. This is in the creative section, gentlemen. This is artists doing their art. All right, I'm gonna tighten this up a little bit so I'm not running off the end of the page down here. Oh, Nadine Amin. Greetings from Colombia. Very fond of your work. I'm an editorial cartoonist, too. Keep up the good work. Well, thank you very much, Nadine. You're a cartoonist in Colombia? A few years ago, I went on a Cartooning for Peace trip to Colombia. We went to Bogota and did a bunch of events, and it was great fun. And I got to meet a lot of the Colombian cartoonists. Vlado is my buddy now. And I did a speech with Miko in Medellin, which was great fun. And you Colombian cartoonists have wonderful names like Chocolo, Chocolate, and... Bacteria. Kind of fantastic names for cartoonists. Mark 242 on Twitch writes, good night, Daryl Cagle, and chat has been fun. Thank you, Mark 242. I wish you had said a bit much more, but what the hell? I appreciate people saying anything. Wolverine 421 says, say donate. Well, I haven't been saying donate because we haven't set up donate options yet. Getting ahead of myself with so few people watching these. I'm still learning how to do these. But I'm getting better. I've done a few of them. I think I'm past most of my technical problems. Nice to see more people coming on and watching. Wow, not 4chan. Do you know what the term raiding means? No. Is that going to be something dirty? Wow, not. Are you leading me into something that I may regret? So what does the term raiding mean? Okay, there's his flail hand. This is the help me, I'm drowning hand. Get that up. Nadim says, yeah, I know all that, folks. I publish weekly in 2 newspapers here in Colombia. Well, very good. Colombia is surprisingly rich in cartoonists and in cartooning tradition. And it was a Great pleasure to go there and meet the guys. Another cartoonist I like is Matador, who draws for, I think it's El Tiempo. And I think he's great, very simple. And very disturbing to learn how El Tiempo, which does a wonderful bunch of cartoons and looks like a nice cartoon-supportive publication, requires those guys to submit like 3 or 4 rough sketches for every cartoon, and then they just print very few of what's submitted to them. Yeah, I can't see how you can make a living as a cartoonist in Colombia. Just terribly frustrating. Okay, we've got more people talking to each other on Twitch. And I think I'm not part of that conversation. Lazarus on YouTube writes, I don't know how these candidates can slam each other, then throw their support behind the lead candidate. Very hypocritical. Well, lesser of two evils, I get that. They're talking to Republican audiences who hate Democrats. They've got to show their fealty. I could have drawn multiple arms on him in multiple arm flailing. Should I do that? Arm? That's just too much, isn't it? Nadim writes, you're always welcome here in Colombia. I'll send you greetings to all the boys here. Hey, Nadim, do that. Tell them I really enjoyed my visits to Bogota. I gave a speech, I think, at the big university in Medellin with Miko, which was awkward because, you know, Miko's this big, huge cartoon star in Colombia, and I appreciate that he wanted to do that and go out to dinner with me, but he doesn't speak a word of English. I don't speak any Spanish, and we had kind of an awkward time trying to talk to each other, have any kind of conversation. Some of those guys, like Chocolo, Vlado, excellent English. Also on that trip to Bogota a few years ago, I got to know Tinius, who was one of the French cartoonists that got murdered in the Charlie Hebdo attack. And that was my opportunity to get to know him. And he was just a gentleman. And so really very sad and disappointing. It's a wonderful opportunity to meet and get to know Tignu. Meet and get to know all those Colombian cartoonists. Colombia is a lovely place. I love the weather in Bogota. The thin, crisp air. Actually, the weather in Medellin is just fantastic. It's like the perfect climate on Earth. Medellin is beautiful. I understand the Colombian cartoonists meet really very seldom. Okay, wow, not 4chan. Are you the Bob Ross of political cartoons? You know, I'm going to start doing some how-to videos. I know Twitch says they don't want how-to videos, so they probably live more on YouTube. And I know that my drawing, my regular cartoons, is kind of in the nature of a how-to. Well, clearly I'm not the Bob Ross of editorial cartoons, because I don't have very many people watching this. And I don't know what the hell the people on Twitch are talking about. Kiddope45, follow me. Yes, oh, that's very nice. Thank you. You should have an AFO during your streams. I don't know what an AFO is. I'm just starting this. Wow, not 4chan. I'm a newbie here, and I really don't know what the hell I'm doing. I know what I'm doing when I draw my stupid cartoon, so I'm endeavoring here to talk all the time like some idiot savant skill while I'm really thinking about the drawing. And perhaps I'll be able to develop that skill more as time goes by. So is this what the chat is going to be like on Twitch? Lots of people just talking about a lot of nonsense to each other? Mark242 writes, how old are you, man? How old do you think I look, Mark242? Alright, eyeball, eyeball. If I was brave, I would draw the eyeballs last, but I'm not so brave. Not looking right. The neck is looking a little bit not as sophisticated as I would like. So let's get to those nostrils. Remember that show on Cartoon Network, Cow and Chicken? I liked that show. And I liked those giant bold nostrils on Cow. I can't quite make that fit with my drawing style, but I think about that when I draw the big bull nostrils, and it makes me draw them a little bit bigger. Lazarus writes, growing an audience is hard. Sometimes it seems YouTube popular artists are geared toward younger people. You know, it's easier to see the arts community on Twitch Creative, and I haven't really been able to identify streaming artist community on YouTube. Maybe I'm just not looking in the right place. I'm streaming this to both YouTube and Twitch. So I've got two chat windows open. And it looks like the stream is just as good on either YouTube or Twitch. So wherever you are, if you would like or subscribe to my stream, I do appreciate it. Lazarus writes, some of the people with lots of followers are 25 and younger and have 10,000 subscribers, but they draw lots of mermaids, one-eyed girls, and unicorns. Oh, hell. I hardly ever draw topless girls. And I draw lots of business suits. Sorry about that. Politicians in business suits are not something I think that's of much interest to many 25-year-olds. And of course, my cartoons are drawn for newspapers. I have just about half of the daily paid circulation newspapers in America that subscribe to my cartoons. And, you know, 25-year-olds, not the best newspaper readers. I also find, to my shock and dismay, that the age of the readers on Cagle.com, my website, is old and getting older. Well, maybe there's a way to young it up, I don't know. But I can say that this is something that worries newspapers and worries editorial cartoonists. Now, one thing that's kind of cool is that bastard George W. Bush. Snowman42, I would love to donate you money and see how rich I am. Well, thank you, Snowman42. I haven't set up any donate options because I'm just starting to do this, but I will in the future. But I appreciate that. If you subscribe, I appreciate it. And all you other people, I don't know what the hell you're talking about. Talking to each other. I guess it's fine. Just finding any kind of chat room somewhere to chat with each other happens to be my live stream, huh? Yaga writes from Puerto Rico. Thank you, Yaga. I think the Twitch app for the iPhone is super laggy and can't even watch you from it, writes Lancal V77. I haven't even looked at that. How come there's so many more of you on my chat than there are showing up as how many people are in the stream? I don't get it. Thank you, Spider Pig T, for following. Lazarus writes, I want to see more editorial cartoonists do live stream. Mike Lukovich will post a time-lapse video of his cartoons on Facebook. You know, Steve Sack does a wonderful time-lapse video of his cartoons, but he draws the whole cartoon on his iPad, and he records it with an app. So it's an easy thing to do if you do it on an iPad. I don't know, maybe Mike Lukovich does that. I haven't seen his speeded up video. Problem with me speeding one up is that I draw on paper and I'm turning the paper all the time. So, it's not as clean and pretty as something recorded for an iPad all in the same position. Okay, I guess that's right. Yeah, I would love to see like a whole channel of editorial cartoonists. You know, we represent a lot of cartoonists at Cagle.com. But, hey, all of you Twitch people that are chatting about other things, why don't you just subscribe to me? And that would be very nice. Okay, the rope goes around this way. Ropes are forgiving. I'm going to make this more of a noose kind of rope. I'm going to get rid of this knot at the top. One knot here is all the knot it needs. Mad Bomber. So if you're a nerd for watching video games on Twitch, you're not a nerd for watching newspaper editorial cartoonist on Twitch. Now you've graduated to a whole different level. In fact, you know, editorial cartoons are on state mandated AP social studies testing in 8th and 11th grade in every state in America. And teachers teach the test. Perhaps you're just doing your homework by watching me. I'll bet if you're still in high school, you could get extra credit just for sitting down and watching this video. At least it's a pitch. I don't know if you guys ever hear me talking about soccer and video games. Lazarus writes, I think you made a good point that the younger generation are not newspaper readers or keep up with the news in general. You know, even among the ones that keep up with the news, I think they don't like the curated experience of a newspaper. And I noticed that with websites that do a curation of the news kind of deal. Also being unpopular with young people. We just saw Al Jazeera America go out of business, which is interesting, and people are all saying that's because of American audience not liking their Arabic logo. But I think that's not the case. I think they're curating the news and doing long-form journalism, which at the time was something that was lauded as a good thing, but then that's not going to pick up an audience, particularly if you have a negative image from being perhaps a bit anti-American. But I rather liked Al Jazeera America. And I thought the anti-American stuff about them was overblown. I didn't notice a whole lot of that going on. All right, drawing the shoe here. Oh, Scott A. Shepler. Thank you for coming on YouTube, Scott. Thanks, Daryl, for trying this. I've done some editorial cartooning in the past for local newspapers and have always enjoyed it. Watching another artist's creative process is a great learning process. Well, thank you for the kind words, Scott. Yeah, you know, the idea behind this was I thought, you know, if I could get past all the fear hurdles and the tech hurdles and actually get a process going for where I'm drawing online all the time, then it shouldn't take any more hours out of my day. It really should take me just as long to draw a cartoon if I'm talking like an idiot savant as if as if I'm drawing it normally, quietly, with the talking heads on the news in the background. All right, I gotta read through all of these Twitch comments to find out if there's a comment for me. A little bit of undershoe perspective. I'm not sure I like that shoe. I might draw that over. This under the shoe, I guess, is okay. My apologies for being so indecisive. I am indecisive. That's why, a big reason why I draw in pencil. I figure stuff out as I go along, and I make lots of mistakes. And I think a lot of beginning artists will start off with a blank piece of paper and ruminate and worry about what they're going to do. Whereas what you need to do is just jump in there and draw it and make the mistakes and not worry that you made the mistakes. Getting phone messages at the same time that I'm drawing. Lazarus writes, I try to let my friends know about this live stream and even share your post on my timeline. That's very nice of you, Lazarus. Once I get a little bit more comfortable with this, I'm going to have a spot on Cagle.com that announces further in advance when I'm doing the next live stream. I have to adjust my own lifestyle for that and not decide at the last minute, oh, I want to draw a cartoon. No. Which I'm used to doing. Then I will keep my appointment. But I really need to have more viewers before I commit to doing that. Hey, all you Twitch people chatting over there, come subscribe to me. Hurting for subscribers. I'm not asking for donations, just asking for subscribers. Okay, is that shoe bitter? I think it's a little bit bitter. Okay, heel pops up. I'm missing that appeal to the rest of the soul distinction in this view. Is that a good foot? Does that look like he could just slip that off of his foot? Well, if he could, he's not aware of it, is he? Perhaps that makes it even more of a good metaphor. So, Spider Pig T on Twitch writes, low-level tunes in their own territory are the only exception. Make it so. Oof. Oh, I'm not sure I even understand that. Phantom Mott writes, who is your top donator? I'm not asking for donations on Twitch. At least not yet. I have not gotten comfortable enough with the process to yet do that. Although I probably will, because editorial cartoonists don't do that well financially these days. So, so Twitch people, subscribe. I'm not asking for donations. Just subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. Please subscribe. I need subscribers. As you chat with each other, subscribe. Lee Hawkeye writes, do you like Pepsi or Coke? I like Coke. I do not like Pepsi. The way you guys chat, I don't know if you're asking questions from me. Alright, I think this shoe is getting about right. This is actually kind of a challenging shoe to draw inside of this noose here. Fascinating to see the price of oil drop like this. Fascinating to see how it's going to affect the world. It might be bad. We might see countries just want to jump into war because the price of oil is so long. Number One Kills writes, how long have you been streaming for? I think this is about my fifth one. The first four, I'm obviously dealing with technical stuff. Although, if you want to look back on my drawing the previous four cartoons, I think there's plenty to look at, but no, I'm new to this, and I'm not aware of any other editorial cartoonists who do live streams. I see people doing crafty things on Twitch Creative, and I like watching the sculptors. And I see people drawing comics and web comics and stuff. You know, I may need to just abandon this idea of this ridge in the oil barrel because it's not working with a. Oh, Lazarus writes, regular Coke or Coke Zero? Oh, I drink caffeine-free Diet Coke. I guess that ages me, huh? Jessica writes, this chat sucks. I'm sorry, Jessica. Okay. Rotka 76780 really likes it here. Well, nice to have you here, Rotka. Lewis OFG, now I get to watch you more. Well, thank you, Lewis OFG. Okay. Bum, bum. This oil can is giving me hell. But you know, it's a cartoon. If I was doing a real illustration, I had to get the perspective right. This would be a whole lot of stress and work. But of course, it's a cartoon. It should not be stressful. Is that right? Let's fix this a little bit. It should look a little goofy, distorted oil can rather than correct oil can. Otherwise, it wouldn't look right in my cartoon universe. There we go. Hey, all of you 40 Twitch people, come on and subscribe to me. It costs nothing. I'm not asking for donations. I'm just asking for your subscription. Come on, guys. I need to build an audience on Twitch, and I am just getting started, so your help is much appreciated. Okay, oil can. Is that looking right? Yeah, it looks good enough. Let's give it a little crosshatch that would define the three-dimensionality. Lazarus writes, caffeine free at our age. We need all the caffeine to be able to stay up and draw. I tell you, the caffeine gets me drawn like Charles Schultz. The hands go like this. Sometimes, you know, it worked for Charles Schultz, but not so much for me. So much of what I do requires a surety of line, and I am just, I'm not as coffee tolerant as I used to be. Not as caffeine tolerant as I used to be. Alright, this is the oil can. I guess that's looking oil canny enough. Looks like it's tied to a rope, huh? Put that there. Wow, all these people watching on Twitch. Up to 63 now. That's nice. Come say something to me. Ask a question. And subscribe. Don't stop here without subscribing. It's polite to subscribe. You guys need to subscribe. Come on, subscribe to me, please, please. You want to see different kinds of artists on Twitch creative community? See editorial cartoonists? Gotta subscribe. Show that you're interested in different things. Oil. I think that works. It looks like oil, huh? You would know that's oil. Barrel of oil. I think I'm going to give him his in stripes. Lewis OFG writes, will you lick your fingers slower? Lick my fingers? Have I been licking my fingers without thinking about it? I don't think about what I'm doing as I do this, particularly if I'm trying to talk all the time through it. Mm-hmm. All right. Pinstripes. Pinstripes will take a while. Come on, Twitch folks, subscribe to me. Show the love. You come here and watch, and then you don't subscribe. Okay, there we go. Now, when I finish this, I'm going to scan it with high contrast and take it into Photoshop and do the color. And I usually don't, well, I haven't so far shown my process of coloring these cartoons on the previous streams. XX6000LEF1. Anyone on a Mac here? Yeah, I'm on a Mac. FootballKing331 writes, are you sponsored by anyone? No, I don't know about getting sponsored on Twitch. I'd like to learn more about that. Mad Bomber writes, are you a Muslim? No. Not a Muslim. Not a proponent of any particular religious group. Secular editorial cartoonist here. Nadim writes, what's your opinion on digital drawing? Do you use some of those tools? I do. I have a Wacom tablet right here in front of me. And I will use that to color the cartoon. And actually, I can't live without a Wacom tablet now. I gotta color the cartoon on the Wacom tablet. That said, I don't like doing the original drawing on the Wacom tablet because I'm comfortable with a pencil, and I like having original art. And I sometimes sell the original art. And giving up all that, not something I want to do. Now, I do appreciate the other guys who do their entire drawing on a Wacom tablet. And I get it. But not for me. I'm going to stick with the pencil and paper. That said, I might endeavor to show my Wacom tablet coloring process later on. No, I think it's a lot to give up original art, and it's a lot to give up your pencil skills. Pen skills. I love original art hanging on the wall. And I do sell it. And you know, they're very pretty originals. I like this vellum paper. It's really got a very nice quality to it, and I like the look of the pencil line on the vellum. Some people draw so cleanly in ink, they clean up their sketches so tightly with their ink drawings that you can't even tell that it's original. It might as well be just be a good copy. And with a pencil drawing, you can get a little bit of the shininess from this angle or that angle, and it's lovely. Lewis OFG writes, Daryl Cagle, notice me. Okay, Lewis, what do you got to say, Lewis? Did I miss something before? Yeah, he needed the pinstripe suit for you to know that he's Wall Street. I should have known that from the beginning. I had to see him in the shorts and wife beater to realize that was wrong. Sometimes you gotta see it to know it, huh? Number one kills. Yo, man, back from work. How goes it? All good, kills. We were talking about Colombian cartoonists earlier, and there's a cartoonist named Matador, which in Spanish is killer or murderer. Not just the guy who fights the bull, but the murderer of the bull. And, kind of cool to have a cartoonist name that's murderer, killer, killer cartoonist. Cartoonists around the world like to have single names like Madonna or Flipper or Lassie. Matador Killer. Mad Bummer writes, ever play WoW? Daryl Cagle, game is awesome. I don't know WoW. All right, more pinstripes. G.E. Clatter Monclavi writes, you are beautiful. You're talking to me, G.E. Clatter? Thank you so much. These pinstripes can be kind of boring, but I like how they add detail and they describe the three-dimensional form, which is, it's always a challenge. You always want to make the drawing seem more three-dimensional. I'm still not entirely happy with this shoe. Let me go in and fix that a little bit. For me, drawing is a process of erase and fix. So apologies for that. Nadim Amin, what was the subject of your very first editorial cartoon? I don't know. I drew editorial cartoons as assignments in junior high and high school. I had a junior high class that would give me extra credit for drawing editorial cartoons, so I did like 100 for that class. I got an A++. There was no limit on the extra credit. And then I had a physics class in high school that allowed me to draw physics editorial cartoons for extra credit. And I was terrible in physics. I struggled with all the science and the math of it. But I could draw those physics editorial cartoons and rack up the extra credit. And I got an A in physics as well. But I didn't know what the hell was going on in that class. Except that I drew physics editorial cartoons. And there are lots of things to editorialize about physics, actually. Is that better? Maybe it's better. Scott. On YouTube writes, like yourself, I usually do a rough, sometimes analog, sometimes digitally. I almost always do work digitally now with a Wacom, either in Illustrator or Photoshop using a Mac. Wife bought an iPad Pro, but yet to receive iPencil. I'm eager to see what can be drawn with it. And speaking of erasing, that's why I like digital, easier corrections, editing, and lettering. I should note to all you folks over here on Twitch that you can follow me on Twitter at dcagle, D-C-A-G-L-E. So please come do that. And McShadle wrote, do you got Twitter? Yep, I got Twitter, dcagle. Come watch me on Twitter. I've got a lot of followers on Twitter, but they tend to be a little unresponsive. Whereas the ones on Facebook are really quite responsive. Oh. Backbone, right. So you're drinking a fireball? You guys have no idea what I'm drinking. Fireball colored. Is that shoe better? That needs to come in a little bit there. Okay. Yeah, if, Scott, the erasing on this nice vellum is pretty good. I have to erase a hell of a lot to affect this paper, so it's really quite forgiving, and I really don't erase that much. If I did, I'd just draw apart in another spot and do a patch, and then the original isn't that good, but I get the job done. Nadim writes, what is that drawing that you always wanted to make and still haven't? Well, I tell ya, I used to work for a newspaper. I used to have an editor. And I struggled with the constraints of working with an editor and not being able to draw many of the things I wanted to draw. And now I'm my own editor. And I don't have those constraints, except that if I was to draw something offensive, my subscribing newspapers would not print it. And sometimes I draw things that they don't want to print, and I get some angry letters from the editors, but not very often. Part of doing editorial cartoons is you want to get other people to suffer from your opinion. Big Shouks writes, this seems as good a place as any to waste a part of my life watching someone play a video game. Hi, Daryl Cagle. Well, all right. No video games here. This is Twitch Creative. Here we draw. Here you have a window on my studio. Here you can sit all day watching pinstripes be made. Anyway, with no editor, I can draw whatever I want, so I don't really worry about not being able to draw what I want. What kind of mouse do you use? Writes Flaming Deuce. I use this $79 fancy Apple mouse because it's nice and wireless, and I've used up all of my USB ports. So, needed the wireless. Wolverine421 writes, happy to see you live. Thank you very much, Wolverine. You and everyone else here on Twitch, please, please, please subscribe to me. Okay. Note that I don't ask you for money, just for a nice subscription. A nice no-cost subscription. So that I can perhaps look a bit more popular than I am so far. That's kind of making sense, I think. You see me looking in these different directions. I'm looking at what the screen, what's up, showing up on the screen, and I'm reading the chats, which can be a challenge because I don't know what a heck of a lot of you folks are talking about. Okay. Give him a little bit of shade in his big midsection. Some under the lapel shade. I should say that my last streams of my previous cartoon drawings are available on my YouTube page. So go there, search for Daryl Cagle, and they're easily found. And I find that when people look at the YouTube videos of these, I think they spend about 2 minutes on it, and they flip through different parts to get a sense of how the thing progressed. That's all right. G Clatter Monclavi asks if I have a cute girlfriend. Oh, G Clatter, are you a potential cute girlfriend? Oh, there's hoping you don't. Shame on you, Daryl Cagle. What's this shame for? Snowman 42. So, bulls are Wall Street. And I'm not going to put a Wall Street label on them, because you should know that a bull is Wall Street. You should know that the stock market is crashing now because the price of oil is sinking, dragging the stock market down with it. That's basically all this cartoon is. This is a declarative cartoon. This is, look out there. Stuff is, the oil is sinking, dragging down the stock market. Here it is. Visually, look, this is what's happening. Ah! Yeah, that's what's happening. That's really all the cartoon is. Not much of an opinion expressed here. But that's all right. A large part of the news is declarative without much of an opinion. All right, is he looking good with his pinstripes? Does he need a little bit more? I think he probably needs a little bit more going on. A little bit more shadow under this arm. There we go. Noodle Keep says, love the stream, bro. Always entertaining. Well, thank you very much, Noodle Keep. I appreciate that. Be sure to subscribe. Is he looking right? Am I satisfied with him? Am I ready to go draw the water and the fishes? Got some fishes going on here. People have been telling me that I should put music in my stream. And frankly, I don't like music in a stream. So no music in a stream for me. You can play your own music, and I won't disturb you. Drawing the water now. Cartoon water, so it's for giving. There are lots of animators who specialize in things like just doing water. I think that's a boring life as a cartoonist. What do you draw as a cartoonist? Oh, I draw fire. Oh, where else do you draw? Oh, I did the fire in this movie and the fire in this movie. Boring, fire, water, clouds, smoke. You want to make your career drawing just that? Or make your career forcing your opinions upon others? That's the way to be a cartoonist. All right, that water's looking wrong over there. few more bubbles and things going on here. We'll start doing a little bit of water texture. And I'll get down to the fishes around the oil drum. Refresh here on Twitch. All right. Just to remind you folks of what's going on. This is a cartoon I did previously, Obama as an anchor and the poor Democrats as being sunk by Obama. So I was thinking of that when I thought of this one. This is oil sinking the stock market. Basically the same thing. Looks like Twitch is having some technical difficulties. Shows me as offline. Let's see if you folks start coming back. After being offline. Yeah, right. Water. I think the Twitch stream is working again. Looks like I've got my 69 viewers back. That's kind of nice. You guys stuck with me as the stream went offline? Are you still in there talking to each other? Underwater. I like Twitch. I like the creative community on Twitch. I like the idea of having multiple windows open and looking at different people's drawing boards at the same time. Window to the creative world. And if having people here through the process works, then I've got an entirely different thing to do than I have done in the past, which is just look at my finished cartoon. Like Twitch is having chat troubles. Wait just a second here. Okay. The water details. Well, the chat certainly seems to have died down with Twitch issues. And YouTube has gone quiet as well. So it's back to just me here. Oh, I think the chat room might be working again on Twitch. If that starts going. I've got a little piece of sandpaper over here on the side at the right that I use to give my pencil a chisel point. See the chisel point? Pat and flat. Bubbles around. This water is going to have a blue color, which is going to tie it together as a big flat area. Scott writes that he's watching but doing dishes at the moment. Well, good planning to have your computer there to watch while you do the dishes. Looks like the chat is disabled on Twitch. 54 people watching and no chat. Sorry about that, folks. But if you are watching and wishing you could chat, what a good time to subscribe. Think about which way the water goes. That wasn't a real good pencil. Okay. Boy, I even get more people watching when they can't chat on Twitch. Maybe that's an advantage, huh? Oh, Twitch tells me that my stream configuration quality is excellent. Oh! Well, I feel good about that. So if I'm configured so well, why don't you have the chat working? It's just not working. Okay. Let's draw these little fishes. Thank you. Now, Deem writes, what's your opinion on the meme phenomenon? Do you think it puts in danger our jobs as cartoonists? Well, I don't like memes. Memes are subject of bitter discussion among cartoonists. Because, as you know, we cartoonists, we like to... we do this because we want to express our opinions. Otherwise, why the hell aren't you doing... something that pays better. I could be working in animation in Hollywood, sitting in a cubicle doing storyboards and do better than this. But I love doing the editorial cartoons. I like having my drawings look like I drew them rather than drawing other people's characters the way they want them, as I did through most of my career. So... wonderful things about being an editorial cartoonist. And memes, I'm always getting people saying, you know, you should do, put your cartoons up and leave them blank and let people put their captions in your cartoons. And why would I want to do that? The whole purpose of doing the cartoons is that I want to have my thing to say. Having my cartoon be there as a blank for someone to have what they want to say. Forget that. Do something else. That's not so rewarding to me to just do the blank that other people want. So there's three fish on that side, a couple more fish over here. Another thing I don't quite get is this caption contest phenomenon that the New Yorker seems to be so invested in. Strikes me as nothing more than a meme. Possible that I'll move these fish around a bit when I get it into Photoshop. Jackson Coleman on Twitter writes, how long did that cartoon take? Well, at this point, we're at 1 hour and 39 minutes, Jackson. And, that's actually pretty long. But if I figure... typical editorial cartoon's going to take a couple of hours to draw and a couple of hours to color, post, and process. That would be a good one. A more complex one can take longer. This one's really pretty simple. So, memes, caption contests, I do not like them. Let people do that on other sites, not with my cartoons. Can you imagine a columnist writing a column and putting it up like a blank and say, hey, you folks, why don't you change the words in my column to reflect your own opinion and then post it with my name on it all over the web? It doesn't make much sense when you talk about it in terms of columnists. And of course, editorial cartoonists are graphic columnists. But no. I want to write the caption. I want to do the meme. You should draw cute kitties. You know, cute kitties. There's a cartoonist in Tunisia named Willis, who for all of her editorial cartoons, the only characters in the cartoons are kitties. And, you know, that's... I think that's the key to the internet is cute kitties. Kind of a business plan there, huh? Maybe my cartoons would do better with cute kitties as in everything. Although, how would I draw this cartoon with cute kitties? I've got a bull and fish. Sometimes good business sense doesn't make any sense. Kitties! bowls. The fish might have bubbles, huh? So I think I'm going to do a how-to video of how I color my cartoons. I'll do that pretty soon. And that's going to work for all the cartoons. You really don't need to see each one of these colored. All the creative decisions that I'm making through the process are done while I'm drawing. I come to it with a general concept and then figure out how to draw it while I draw it. Okay, now I'm going to move the sheet down a little bit and move the floor of the ocean up just a skosh. More graceful at that. Alright, I think that looks right. So, ocean floor here. I could have a little crab. I think I should draw a little crab over here, like right on this little spot here. Little crab is kind of fun. Be like a little lobster. It's kind of a little lobster guy, huh? You can see antennas. I may decide to take him out because he's just a distraction. But he's nice there for a minute. All of you folks that are watching and not commenting on Twitch, please, please, please subscribe to me. A little bit of flowy seedweed going on here. The ground's looking okay. Sorry, you folks on Twitch. It looks like Twitch is having chat problems. Tells me the chat will be available in 2 seconds, but then that doesn't happen. So my apologies, but thank you for staying on and watching even while you cannot chat. Or perhaps you're chatting and I just cannot see. Extra bubbles down here. You know, it looks like there's nothing going on with all of this water. It's taken me quite a while to draw a bunch of nothing going on, isn't it? am I pleased with this? Back to my fireball. I guess it's okay. The oil is sinking down about as low as it can go, huh? Below $30. Not that much farther to go. I'm not sure a lot of people on Twitch sit around worrying about how their 401ks are doing. But perhaps this is not the most salient issue for you guys. Okay. Yep. Looks like Twitch is struggling here. People have been writing to me to draw El Chapo and Sean Penn. And I don't have anything to say about El Chapo and Sean Penn. I don't really care. I mean, he's bad. Good to catch him. But I don't have anything extra to say that has any value that adds to the conversation. No opinion beyond, he's bad, good that they caught him. So I'll forget El Chapo. Alright, let's move this over here, put my signature in. Thank you folks for staying with me so long. I appreciate that. So I'm going to be done in just a second. Then I will bid you adieu and I will go to color this in Photoshop, which will not be on the live stream because I'm just afraid it's too boring. It is part of my my daily grind lifestyle sitting here, and perhaps one day I shall include it in the stream, but it is quite boring. Get this stream of bubbles looking more like it's stream going through here. It's looking good. This stream over here is looking good. So I got two bubble streams going on. I am thinking about making up actual details here in the ocean in which Wall Street sinks. Alright, I guess that's looking right. Let's put politicalcartoons.com in here. Alright, is there any last little butsy things I want to do in here? Do I want to take the lobster out? I think the lobster can remain. All right. That's looking right. There he is, dragged down by the sinking price of oil. Poor Wall Street. And I'm all set. Here he is sideways. So you can see him in all in one view. And there he is, the poor bull. Getting sunk down by the oil. I was covering up my camera, sorry. And I guess that's it. So, hey, thank you so much, folks. Please do remember to subscribe to my channel, both on Twitch and on YouTube. Visit me on Twitter at dcagle. Look up Daryl Cagle on Facebook, and you can find me. And you can also find my Facebook fan page at facebook.com/politicalcartoons. Visit my website at darylcagle.com and our pay-per-use website at politicalcartoons.com. So many things for you to look at and subscribe to. It's a Daryl Cagle Fest. Thank you for this, coming and visiting me here, and I will post the time for the next drawing that I'm going to do on Facebook and Twitter a little bit in advance. And probably next I'm going to do a video on how I color these cartoons. Finally put that question to rest with an easy answer, which is go watch my fine how-to video. And if you're watching the how-to videos, of which there is so far one, let me know what you think. Let me know what you'd like to see that's different. And Scott says, great treatment on water and seafloor. Great stream. Thanks again. Thank you very much, Scott. And goodbye to all of you nice 89 people on Twitch for whom chat is not working. But I appreciate you coming in to look. And please, 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 as I turn this stream off, as I turn the stream off and you're seeing this drawing for the last time, subscribe to me. Thank you so much for coming, and good.